Hello everyone, in this lesson I will show you how to export your trading robot from StrategyQuant to MetaTrader 5 trading platform and run it live. As a first step, we will install MetaTrader 5 on our computer and prepare everything which we need to have for running trading robots. So, the first step need to go to the amfutures.com website, then click MetaTrader 5, get started with your free demo now, fill all required credentials and download and install the platform. There is nothing special about this installing, just install it on your computer and run it live. I have installed the platform on the computer and now it's time to activate your demo account. Amfutures offers full functionality 1 month demo account with all data feeds, etc. And so it's quite comfortable for you to use it. Only what you need to do is to activate this account. So you can go to accounts, right click, click open account, then leave it as it is, click next and select open demo account, click next and fill all the credentials. It's important to fill correct email and correct cell phone, because you will receive right after filling it, in next step you will receive confirmation codes and you need to insert it here for activating the platform. So I already done it. You can then fill it, click next, fill the codes, and after this, your platform will be online. You can recognize it here in the left down corner, the right down corner where there is status that platform is connected. If it's not connected, then you can see small red bullet here. So this was the second step. Installation, and then before we will proceed to the activating our robot, we need to copy custom indicators from StrategyQuant into MetaTrader platform. Many users are missing this step and then trading robots are not working correctly. Therefore, please do not avoid it and we will do it right now. So where we can find the custom indicators? On your disk, it's usually disk C, you have folder where you installed your StrategyQuant software. In my case, it's StrategyQuant 131. And so let's go open this folder, then click custom indicators folder, then select your platform. In this case, it's MetaTrader 5, then click indicators. Select them all and click copy. Now let's move back into MetaTrader 5 platform, click file, open data folder, then click MQL5, indicators, right click and insert all indicators. After this step you need to restart your trading platform. So I closed trading platform MetaTrader 5 and open it again. I'm back. Here you can see that here are new StrategyQuant indicators which are required for running trading robot. And now we have our platform prepared. So to make some short resume, installed the MetaTrader 5 platform, we've activated the account, then we copied all custom indicators from StrategyQuant folder into MetaTrader 5 and restarted the platform. Now we'll move to the next step, which is exporting strategy from StrategyQuant, your training strategy, and activating, importing it into MetaTrader 5. So here we have StrategyQuant. Here I have some example strategy, which I will export. And let's continue. So in the full settings, as you are exporting into MetaTrader 5, you need to make sure that one setting is on. It's important to check it. And this setting is called don't trade on weekends. So here, make sure that it's on. And here, let's set 21 p.m. And here, set 23 p.m. So you need to have this set correctly. And if it was not set, then you need to set it and then perform backtest once more. Okay, so we've done this step. Now we can move to the results tab, source code, and here in the select box, select expert advisor for MetaTrader 5. So select it and click save to file. So I save it. Just remember folder where you save it, and so because later you will need to import it into MetaTrader 5. And that's all in StrategyQuant. We've exported our strategy source code. So now we can move back to the MetaTrader 5 and import the strategy. Here I have the folder where I saved the strategy. So now I'll just right click, copy it. And then back in MetaTrader 5, click File, Open Data Folder, MQL5, click Experts, and here paste it. Once you paste it, double click on it, and the code editor will open. And then click compile, see this icon. Strategy is being compiled and everything is fine. So I can close the code editor and close this as well. And here you can see that strategy is ready in this tree. And that's it. We have strategy in the MetaTrader 5. Now, the final step is ahead of us, and in this step, we need to select correct graph and time frame on which we will run the strategy. We can find symbol in the Market Watch window, where we can right click, click show all, and then select the right symbol, drag it and drop it here. After a few seconds, symbol is here, and here we can select right time frame. As you can see, there is quite many symbols here, and so you need to know which is the correct one. And now, let me switch to presentation for a few moments, and I will explain you how to select correct ticker from this list. So how to select right contract, which we will use for running our strategy. For creating strategies, we used continual contracts, for example, at ET. But for trading, we will use current contract, for example, MESH21. What does this symbol MESH21 means? It consists of three parts. Symbol, which is MES, then H, which is contract month, and 21, which is year. And today is January 2021, and therefore we have year 21 here. The symbol is obviously the symbol we're using for creating the strategy. Next slide, I will show you a list of symbols where you can select the correct one. And the remaining part is H, which is contract month. And here is a difference between Forex, where we always have the same ticker, and futures, where we need to switch ticker 4 times a year. Now the question is how to switch it. On the right side we have table where we have expiration month, symbol and expiration date. You can see 4 months here, March, June, September and December. And in the next column there is symbol, so March is linked to H, June to M, September to U and December to Z. And the third column is expiration date, and it's the most important value here, because we always need to choose a contract which expiration date is ahead the current date. For example, today is the 5th of January, therefore I will choose expiration date March 11. And in this case I will use symbol H. So complete ticker, which I will look for in a MetaTrader 5 platform, will be MESH21. In case that we'll move on, and if current day would be April, for example, the first week of April, in this case we need to use June contract. Simply, always before this date happened, we need to switch to the next contract. And if we will do this 1 or 2 weeks ahead of this date, then we'll be fine. It's nothing difficult, just set some reminder into your calendar, and 4 times a year you will need to switch all your contracts. Futures contract. And also the question is where to find expiration date. It's quite easy, just to Google futures contract expiration date 2021 or 2022, and you will see all those dates. So we explained from which parts the ticker consists, and now we know how to select the contract month, the year is obvious, and the symbol is remaining. So how to select correct symbol? We were using in StrategyQuant some tickers for developing strategies. For example, S&P 500 ET, Micro Nasdaq 100 MN, Micro Russell 2000 RX and Micro Dow Jones YR. And here are StrategyQuant tickers, and in MetaTrader 5 there are tickers like this. So for ET we will use MES, for MN we will use MNQ, and etc. The strategy I will import now were developed with the ticker ET in StrategyQuant. Therefore we will use ticker MES. So now let's move back to the MetaTrader 5 and select the ticker MESH21. We are back in MetaTrader 5, and this market watch will find ticker MESH21. We'll drag it and drop it here. Great, we have ticker. So just a few thoughts. If you cannot find the ticker here, just right click and make sure that you click show all, and so all tickers are here. And also you can click to the symbols here, right click and symbols. And for example, if you will search for S&P 500, which is S and S&P, you can filter it here and search for tickers my easier way. In our case it was MESH21, so there is less ticker here, and you can easier find your one. But let's move back, we have ticker here, and the second important step is to select the correct time frame. We know that our strategy was developed for H1, 1 hour time frame. So here I will switch 1 hour. And now the final step is ahead of us. I have already strategy here, so I can drag it and drop it on the graph. Here, so let's switch to the tab common, click allow live trading and click OK. Here you can see that there is a red bullet because we have not turned yet the live algo trading. To turn it on, you can switch here, click, and now you can see that the bullet is green, which means that the trading robot is trading. If trading robot will open a trade, you will find it here in this toolbox on the first tab, trade. If there will be some errors, then you can find it here in the experts tab. This tab is also important if you will face any issues and you decide to contact us, then please always to check this tab and copy the last messages from this tab. It will help us to find the reason of the problem. And that's it. We have a trading robot. It's live and it's trading. So congratulations. And let me give you some final thoughts to let it run and to let this trading robot trade live. You need to leave your trading platform on, which means you need to find some computer or a VPS where you will run your trading platform constantly without interruption. And once you turn off this trading platform, then open position will remain still open, but this trading robot cannot manage them. So it's the final thought. Thank you for your attention.